Correspondent Brianna Keeler has been working this story for us. A ban on so-called earmarks. Let's give some perspective, though, on this. It's billions of dollars, but in the scheme of things, it wouldn't really change all that much dramatically.
When you do look at total government spending, it's true, it is just a fraction. In fact, if you look overall, you'll see that most of government spending, $2.2 trillion of it, goes to Medicare, Medicaid, Social Security, and earmarks aren't attached to this. But look at this purple chunk over here. This is discretionary spending. You know, this is what funds the Energy Department, the Education Department, the Defense Department. That's $1.4 trillion. This is where earmarks go. See that little sliver, yellow sliver, $10.2 billion amount, about. So in the scheme of things, you might say, hey, that's chump change, Wolf. But actually, it's very significant because critics of earmarks say this is what makes things ripe for corruption, that lobbyists can put campaign donations towards candidates and they can get earmarks in exchange.
$10 billion is still, when all is said and done, $10 billion, exactly. Nothing to sneeze at. Explain the difference between what the Democrats are proposing in terms of earmark reform and what the Republicans are proposing.
Well, first off, the ban that Democrats proposed yesterday that we discussed, this would be a ban on earmarks that go to for-profit companies. But then today, Republicans came out and they said, we want a ban on all earmarks. So it would be for for-profit companies, but it would also be for, you know, nonprofits or money that goes to states for public works projects, money that goes to universities and the like.
And these proposals are in the House right now. What about the Senate?
Yeah, in the Senate, it's a different story. In fact, Democrats, for instance, the top Democrat on the spending committee in the Senate, Daniel Inouye, he completely panned this idea. And then you have Republicans who are kind of split on this. Some of them may want to see earmark reform like this, but others say, you know, this is our prerogative, and this is also a check that we have on President Obama's budget. Actually, one Senate Republican aide said to me, this is a political ploy on the part of Democrats and Republicans in the House. And even though we talk so much, Wolf, about how there isn't a lot of bipartisanship on the Hill, as you know, there's certainly a bipartisan love of these earmarks.
Yeah, they like that money.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks very much, Brianna Keeler.